Howdy, folks. Well, as you can see, I got a Vornado. And this is a pretty good size one, too. Motor spins perfectly freely. Don't see any mechanical problems with it. On the back, however, this is what we got. A friend of mine who used to live here in Alabama found this near his new home where he lives, and I think it was actually in the trash somewhere, and he saved it for me, and I just now received it. So I've already done a little bit of preliminary checking, and unfortunately it does look like the motor is open circuit. So this one, it very likely is going to require in-depth work to make it run again. So don't expect any kind of action tonight on this video. This is just a preliminary kind of checkout video. So now you can see the meter, and I'm measuring resistance. So these two wires down here go to the motor, and as you can see, it's open. So what that means is I'm going to take the motor out, and these lead wires feel kind of flaky, so maybe I'll get away with just changing the lead wires and getting it running again, but we shall see. Start with a little penetrating oil. This thing looks like it's seen some moisture. Get the speed coil off. If and when I manage to get this working, I'll have to put out a wanted to buy on motor cover for this fan, because part of the reason these things look so neat is because they have that bullet-shaped motor cover that sits inside here. Without that, it's kind of plain looking. All right, this thing is supported in rubber grommets. It's really intricate, so I'm not going to try to video taking it apart, because I'm going to have my, my face right up there in it. So I'll come back in a few minutes. So after getting the motor out, I found out they've drilled and tapped these four holes in the side of it. And those go through the shell and into the stator laminations. So if I take this apart and I can't get that to line back up exactly, it's going to be a problem. A little customized motor there. Well, much as I hate to say it, this one is toast. You see where it's arced right there? That's a break in the winding, and all this is charred, separated, so this one's burned out. Howdy, folks. Fixing to start on my Vornado motor rewind attempt. Attempt one, that is. I don't know how many it'll take. Like I said, I've never done this before, had no formal training, no guarantees it's going to work out, but I'm going to give it my best shot. If any motor is going to be rewindable by someone who doesn't know what they're doing, it'll be this one, because it's so simple. It's just a shaded pole little motor. I went ahead and took the old windings off, and this is one example. I counted how many turns were in there, and wrote that down. And I also measured the size of the opening in here. So hopefully I'll be able to make another coil or a set of four that are about that same dimension, same number of wraps. I got the materials today. This is the magnet wire. It's rated for 200 degrees C. The Kapton tape to tie the top of the coils together. Also rated 200 degrees C. And this is not new, but it's the same kind of thing. It's Nomex paper to make the liner. It goes inside here to protect the coil from the metal. And another thing I did is I put this in the lathe and I polished the outside of it down. I polished the inside of that because I want this to be able to slide together without pressing or driving, since I know I won't get it right on the first try. So yeah, I'm gonna try to make a winding form, something that can wind the coil like that. Try to see if I can make it out of some stuff I got here. Now, unfortunately, I'm not going to have a tripod for at least part of this video, so accept my apologies in advance, and please don't just vote dislike on it because I don't have a tripod. I really apologize, and it's not by choice at this moment. Well, with a little work with the hole saw, I made two plywood discs, and I glued some insulated terminal shields on there. It's just those pieces, and that is right about the size to wind this coil on. And those are glued on there with super glue, so I'm going to put this together like that. And then on the end of it, I've got a crank handle, a bolt on there. And when it's all assembled, I'm going to chuck it in the lathe with the lathe in neutral and use that crank handle to wind the turns of wire on there. So this is the general idea. Just start the wire in there and wind it the correct number of turns. Well, this is my attempt at a winding rig. I have the lathe in neutral where I can turn this by hand easily. And I have the wire up here with a little plastic washer and a rubber bushing for some tension. And a handle where I can turn it. You can see how that's going to work. But I have to count carefully 215 turns of that and then guide the wire. So I'm not going to try to video that, especially without a tripod. So I will wind it up and then come back with some pictures. Okay, that's 215 wraps of magnet wire onto the little coil winding form. Now I'll take it over there to the bench and try to get it off of there without getting it all disorganized. Well, other than the burned condition, it doesn't look all that much different from the original. So now if I can just manage to put some tape on there without getting it all tangled up, I'll be doing well. This tape is Kapton, they call it. It's a high temperature tape. It's designed for this purpose. Well, there's one coil done. I marked the start of the coil there to help me with the polarity. And the old one looks a little smaller. We'll have to see how tough it is to get it in there in the end. Because this is flexible and not bonded together, it shouldn't be that hard, but time will tell. Now if I can do that three more times, I'll be in good shape. All right, some progress. Now, you might notice this winding here, well, that was a learning curve. That one was too small to fit in, so I had to start over. And on my winding form, I moved these four pegs outward about an eighth of an inch on each. And then that size of coil, I was able to get in there. So two more to wind and try to get this thing going together. Well, at this point, that's actually scary. That actually starting to look like a motor again, a stator. So now I've got to hook the coils up together. And I alternated them so they should just bridge across here. One way this way, the other way this way, so that they're north-south for the four-pole motor. If I'm wrong about that, I'm going to leave enough wire so that if I have to take it apart, I can fix it. But at this point, these two are going to go together, those two, and so on. And the last two pair is where the lead wires will connect. The way the Nomex paper is folded up in there, it'll kind of form a little place to tuck the lead wire connections into. So that's what I'm going to hope to do. That's kind of the way the original one looked like it was done. All right, folks, I am about to put this motor back together and make a test run. I do plan to varnish the new coils, but I want to make sure that the polarity's right and that it actually works before I spend the time on it. And once it's varnished, it'll be harder to do anything to it if I got to modify it. So just going to put the top half on the motor and hook it up to power and take a step back and hit the switch. Well, so the moment of reckoning has come. Hopefully the moment of reckoning, not the moment of wrecking. So without further ado, here goes nothing. .9 amps. smoke. So I'm going to go get the blade and put on there and see if it'll pull its fan blade. Obviously, I've got to get some thrust washers for it because that's really bad. But I think all the fiber washers were gone. Like I said, I think it was on fire at one point and all that kind of stuff just burned away. All right, got her clamped in the vise with the Vornado blade. One thing I noticed, the bearings sound terrible. I'm definitely going to have to do some work on that. Moves a lot of air. Alright, that proves my point, and I don't want to ruin the bearings. That proves my point that the motor is functional and wired correctly. So now I'll tear it back down and re-varnish it.